Hello, dear learners. I am Professor Jaseem Ahmed from Faculty of Education, Jamia Millia Islamia. Today, I am going to discuss about a very important topic titled as Agency and Autonomy of Teachers. Both of these variables are very important in the process of teaching and learning and in the life of teachers as professionals. Teacher autonomy, teacher agency, and teacher motivation are positively correlated and results in the active engagement of teachers in teaching and in producing good results in terms of learning outcomes. So, if you want better learning outcomes on the part of the students, you have to take care of these three, that is teacher autonomy, teacher agency, and teacher motivation. Teacher autonomy means the professional independence of teachers, with a special reference to the degree of their independent decision regarding what they teach and how they teach. As far as what they teach is concerned, they teach as per the syllabus. In the preparation of syllabus, teachers' representatives are always present in the body, in the meetings, in the programs which are engaged in the development of the syllabus. So, as far as what content to be taught are concerned, teachers are always there. Now the second question is how to teach. As we all know that teachers enjoy full autonomy on this front, because how to teach, how to transit the classroom, what method of teaching they are going to use, what sort of classroom interaction they are going to use, what sort of teaching resources they are to use, these all depends on the decision of the teacher. Hence, at this front, teachers really enjoy full autonomy. At some point of time, teachers' autonomy is challenged. For example, when teacher is put to other work and teaching is hampered, like in the case of a school management committee functions, where teachers are supposed to be the integral part of the committee, and some of the teachers who are the member of the SMC, are supposed to be present in their meetings in their all decision making process. Similarly, in schools, when midday meal is going on, many teachers are engaged in the process of midday meal and in the process of discipline maintenance by the students during the midday meal process. Similarly, teachers are also engaged in various data collection processes. And here, in these processes, generally teachers' autonomy is hampered, because in one way or the other, directly or indirectly, these processes or these engagements are going to hamper the teaching learning process. Now the question is, why autonomy is important? In this regard, just I am trying to recall you NCF 2005, which states that teachers' autonomy is essential for ensuring a learning environment that addresses children's diverse needs. As much as the learner requires space, freedom, flexibility, and respect, the teacher also requires the same. Because it is the teacher who look after the needs and aspiration of the learners. If they don't enjoy autonomy, how will they perform their noble duties? It is therefore very important that as we provide autonomy to the students, for their potentialities to come out, for their interest to come out, for their aspiration to come out, so that because of this autonomy, students should feel fully hesitant free to whatever they want to say, they want to share with the teachers, they can share. Similarly, teachers should also enjoy autonomy so that they can freely, with full autonomy, with full dependence, they can design, develop, and apply their teaching learning process and their various activities which are academic. Hence, teacher autonomy is important as far as teachers are performing their professional duty with dedication and producing good results. To perform with full autonomy and productivity, teacher needs to strengthen his or her agency. Now, let's see what is teacher agency. teacher agency is basically the ability of teachers to demonstrate the capacity to act, to solve pedagogical problems or any challenges relating to teaching and learning. These agency includes capacity, conditions, resources, a state of acting or exerting power of knowledge and experience, taking action, performing demonstration and activity, etc., relating to teaching. In this way, it is the operational part of the profession of teaching. Teacher agency is the capacity of teachers to act purposefully, to direct their professional growth and contribute to the growth of their students and colleagues. It is professional action of teachers based on their perception and experiences of their scope of action as they navigate accountability to respond to educational dilemmas at hand. The more powerful is your teacher agency, the better will be the teacher performance. Hence, it is very important that the teacher develop their agency with full confidence, with full enforcement, with hard labor, with dedication, because the more powerful is the agency of the teachers, the more effective will be his teaching learning efforts and the more effective will be the outcome of learning on the part of the learners. Now, let's see how to strengthen the teacher agency. Teacher agency can be strengthened by becoming teacher as a reflective practitioner. When you become teacher as a reflective practitioner, you reflect what you read, what you say, what you teach, what you do, and what you think. These reflections can be given to the students, to the colleagues, to your friends, and anybody you are familiar with. Then you should also reflect to yourself, your students, and your colleagues about your day-to-day work, about your teaching, about your learning, about any of your academic work, whatever you are reading, whatever you are writing nowadays. Then take their reflection, that is reflection of your students on your activity, on your behavior, on your teaching, reflection of your colleagues on your academic work, so that you can improve upon all these things. Similarly, you should also write your reflections in the form of articles and papers and get it published in many magazines and journals. Next is by becoming teacher as learner. Whether you think differently or whatever you think differently, write it down and reflect. Attend seminars, conferences, and present papers. Attend in-service programs to make you updated. Attend workshop, webinars on the topic of your choice. Share your ideas in academic groups within and outside the schools. These are the ways through which you reflect teacher as a learner. Next is by becoming teacher as an active partner of professional learning community. Here, each and every teacher should become the part of any of the learning community which are developed and made for the growth and development of teachers in a particular subject. So, as a teacher, you should take the membership of some professional learning community, some professional learning bodies, or any association. For example, if you are a science teacher, you can take the membership of National Science Teachers Association, NSTA. Similarly, if you are a science teacher educator, you can take the membership of the Association of Science Teacher Education, ASTE. If you are an English language or Urdu language or any language teacher, you can take the membership of Association for Language Learning. If you are a social science teacher, you can take the membership of National Social Science Association. Through these associations, you can integrate, you can share your ideas in writing, in the form of paper, in the form of articles, and through these activities, you can update you and you can learn a lot. You can also help others in their growth and development in the process of teaching and learning. Similarly, there is an association of researchers called as AIAER, All India Association of Educational Researchers. Those who are involved and interested in the field of research, they can be the member of this association and they can publish their papers which are published by these associations. In the same fashion, you may share your ideas and experiences and make yourself updated. Hence, we can conclude in this way that all ways and means of professional growth and updating of self to perform better in class and in professional work strengthen agency of the teacher. Now, the question arises, what school should do in this regard at institutional level? Now, a school system must support teacher agency as the strongest tool of social change. More support given to the teachers will result into the better efforts on the part of the teacher in the learning process, teaching process, and it will bring better results on the part of the achievement of the learners. So a school system must support teachers in enriching their agencies. Teachers must be included in decision making process so that teachers may consider themselves as a part of the system. Teachers must be supported in their innovative activities, in their innovation, what they are doing and what they can do. Teacher should be provided funds for professional growth and development, for example, for joining some association, some teachers group, for attending some seminars and conferences, for working on some projects related to their teaching learning process, writing articles and research papers and publishing them in different journals. If a school system support teachers in this way, it is certain that the teacher is going to perform better in their teaching learning process. Similarly, proper appreciation and reward should be given to those teachers who are good performing and who are achieving good in the field of their teaching. Then teachers should also make all professional learning decisions. The school system should make all professional learning decisions only in serious consultation with teachers. And finally, the school system should give teacher choice regarding their professional learning. So, dear friends, we discussed in this presentation about teacher autonomy, teacher agency, and how a teacher can make his agency as a powerful tool by becoming a reflective practitioner, active learner, and by becoming an active member of relevant professional association. Thanks for